this very small amphitheater, maybe one of the smallest rinks for a figure skating competition at the Winter Olympics. Only seats about 6,000 people, if you count the press and everything, just a little bit more, but it makes it for a very cozy, intimate atmosphere. Isabel Brasseur, Lloyd Eisler will skate first in the final flight, then Natalia Mishkuchinyuk and Artur Dmitriev second, then the former Olympic champions Gordieva and Grinkov third, finally Shishkova and Nomov to round it up. Four pairs still to come here. And speaking of Brasseur and Eisler, tonight our Olympic portrait looks at Lloyd Eisler. Now, some people call him fierce. Some people have a different side. They say he's even gentle. He's a man of power and passion. Understood? Misunderstood? Maybe, maybe not. One thing for sure, there are definitely two sides to Lloyd Eisler.
It all depends how you look at it. To some, he's arrogant. To others, noble. No matter. Lloyd Eisler, along with Isabel Brasseur, is a world champion.
I've always given everything I've got and put everything into skating.
I'm very outgoing, and what you see is what you get.
The falls in Albertville dropped them to Olympic bronze. We saw emotion, frustration.
On that particular day, at that particular time, that's how I was feeling. You know, 1 minute later, I mean, when I was standing and Isabel and I were hugging and saying, you know, it's all right, we're going to make it, you know, let's not worry about it. People don't get to see that. They get to see the instant. And maybe I got a bum rap, but it's not something that's bothered me, you know, because I never ever felt guilty about how I reacted, because that was just a natural reaction.
No one knows any better than Isabel. The way she looks at it, he's a rock.
The thing is, the people, the crowd, they only see about 4 minutes of him. And that's all they see from him. I spent 11 months and more in a year with him. But people don't see that. And people don't see that usually most of the time when he's there, all he wants to do is take care of me and take everything he can take on his back. And he always tried to do that no matter in what. So I know that, you know, if he's around, that I won't have any problem with anything.
Because Lloyd, by nature, assumes all the pressure, and in his own way, handles it. That explains the Harley.
I think for me, what it really means to ride my bike is that I can get away. I can get away from the pressure. I can get away from being Lloyd Eisler, the figure skater, being world champion. And I can just travel from here to Toronto or here to Ottawa, and I just love to ride. For me, it's peace and solitude. It's complete freedom from everything else.
Freedom not to be confused with lack of responsibility. Lloyd Eisler, above all, is responsible and motivated.
I'm finished university, and so what to do with that spare time to actually make it productive? For me, it was getting involved in the Big Brothers Association. I couldn't be happier with the little brother that I have. Eric, he's been wonderful. We've been together now for a year. Been a way of giving back and just, I don't know, using some of the knowledge that I've learned through life to help someone else, you know, that has maybe been, you know, not as fortunate, that may not get all the breaks that I've got in life. And by being a big brother, it's really given me the opportunity to utilize all the things that I've learned. And he's been a fantastic little brother, and I love him dearly.
Lloyd Eisler, it all depends how you look at him.
And I am looking at Lloyd Eisler and Isabel Brasseur right now. They're warming up with the rest of the final flight. Just moments ago, talk about an Olympic dream ending not the way you wanted it to end. Mandy Wutzel and Inger Steuer from Germany were on the ice before this final flight. They finished second in the World Championships last year to Brasseur and Eisler. They were skating flawlessly up until a point when Mandy would trip and fall and take the brunt of the blow on her chin and on her chest. She has gone back for medical attention, apparently with a cut on her chin, perhaps a sore jaw, but mostly a very bruised heart. We'll be back with another medical update on that a little bit later, but first an update on the standings. It is an American team, you know.
I just lost Rod.
Schwartz and Koenig are third, but of course the final flight to come, and you can expect that the top four will have the names of the skaters out on the ice. With a preview to set the scene, our commentators, Brian Orser, Debbie Wilkes. Debbie?
Rod, we're... They're open.
Bit of a microphone problem with Debbie and Brian. We're going to get to them in a moment. There's Lloyd Eisler and Coach Eric Gillies, Jose Picard alongside Isabelle Brasseur. They've had some problems with a rib injury that Isabelle sustained. There are the 92 Olympic champions, Natalia Mishkuchinyuk, Artur Dmitriev, second after the technical program. They will skate second as well. Dmitriev, focused. The warm-up always almost a battle of nerves for the skaters. From the coach's box, a look out on the rink. And of course, Ekaterina Gordieva, Sergei Grinkov. Olympic champions turned professional, reinstated. Evgenia Shishkova and Vadim Novov will be the final pairing to skate. The atmosphere here in this building right now, very tense. The other night before the technical program, both Lloyd and Isabelle looked a little nervous, perhaps thinking about that injury. But they skated near flawlessly. Lloyd even complained a little bit after about the judging. He felt that both he and Isabelle could be a little bit higher than third place coming into the free skate. Mishkuchinyuk and Dmitriev skated flawlessly too, and I would expect many people here, including our commentators, would think that it's the skaters who make the mistakes. If anyone makes a mistake, it will cost them a shot at the podium. Debbie and Brian, what about the flight? Isabelle and Lloyd skating first?
I think it's actually a great position. I mean, at this level, you turn every position of, or the order of skating into a positive one. And that's exactly what they've done. They're skating first. They turn it around. This way, they just take the feeling from the warm-up, and they take it right through onto the performance.
A little bit of strategy involved, too. You have to shorten the warm-up. You must consider how you get 6 minutes worth of preparation into five. Take a moment, take a deep breath.
You just keep that feeling of the ice. You keep in touch with the ice, and you just carry it through to when they call your name. And also, they set the pace.
They look at it from the perspective that it's the rest of the field that's going to have to catch them. They want that top spot, although in the bottom of their hearts, what they want is a good skate. That same connection, I love to see them take each other's hands the moment they're waiting for their names to be called.
Some reassuring.